Tesla just doubled supercharger capacity in Singapore. Behind me is Tesla's latest supercharger that just opened in Singapore's Millennial Walk Mall car park. Today, I'm going to give a guided tour of this supercharger as well as talk about the future of EV charging in Singapore. My name is Darren, and click subscribe to stay updated to more videos on Tesla. These Tesla superchargers are located at Millennial Walk Car Park, Basement 1, Lots 194 to 196. The closest car park entrance is Raffles Boulevard, and the closest lift lobby is Lobby B. This is Singapore's second V3 supercharger station, and also the second in Southeast Asia, because this is the only country in the region where Tesla is officially present. I published a video tour of Tesla's first superchargers in Orchard Central 2 months ago, and I'll put a link to the video above and in the description below. These V3 superchargers come with up to 250 kilowatts and are the fastest way to charge your Tesla. While the average EV charging time is 3 hours, these superchargers can add 270 kilometers of range on your Tesla Model 3 in just 15 minutes. That's 60% of your battery on a Tesla Model 3 Standard Range Plus. There are 3 superchargers in this station, and Tesla is currently offering free charging in Singapore. This is a great perk. But some Tesla owners are noticing that sometimes cars are still being parked at superchargers even after being fully charged. With 244 Teslas on the road, according to official numbers from Singapore's Land Transport Authority, the LTA, this may be a problem that more of us will face. I estimate that at least 165 Teslas are being delivered every month, which means, as of this recording on 1st of October, there are 409 Teslas on Singapore's roads. Before I talk about this further and EV charging in Singapore, there's a big piece of news for the Tesla community in Singapore. Tesla Owner Singapore is now an official Tesla club, which means that you can find it in Tesla's official club directory at engage.tesla.com. This news was confirmed by Christopher, who is Tesla Singapore's country manager, at Tesla Owner Singapore's webinar earlier this week. The Tesla Owners Club is a community of owners and enthusiasts who are working hard to advance Tesla's mission of accelerating the world's transition to sustainable energy. Having an official Tesla club in Singapore opens up more partnership opportunities with insurance, charging, bodywork, and more to benefit Tesla's owner community in this country. You can join Tesla Owners Singapore if you currently have a Tesla or are planning to get one in the future. I'll put a link to Tesla Owners Singapore Facebook page and Telegram group down in the description below. Back to EV charging. Tesla Singapore's country manager said that we're likely going to see idle fees being implemented together with pay-per-use supercharging in the future. This would be similar to other markets like the US and China. The Tesla supercharger network is set to expand rapidly, according to a recent tweet by Elon Musk. Shanghai just became the first city in the world to have 100 supercharger stations and 1,000 superchargers in total. Another popular request from Tesla owners in Singapore is the availability of the Tesla wall connector. Fingers crossed, we'll likely see approval for it in November. This will allow Singapore residents to install the Tesla wall connector to charge their EVs overnight at landed homes or condos, subject to approval. The Tesla mobile connector, while available as a default when you pick up deliveries in other countries, isn't available in Singapore because the 3-pin charging isn't approved in this country due to regulations. All of these EV charging developments will help because the popular Tesla Model Y is going to open for orders by end of this year, with first deliveries likely by Q1 2022. I know how excited many of us are for the Model Y in Singapore, and I look forward to getting one myself. I'm confident of this development because Gigafactory Austin and Berlin are going to open up this quarter, freeing up Gigafactory Shanghai to focus its exports on Asia Pacific. At the same time, the LTA plans to install 60,000 new EV chargers in Singapore by 2030, 40,000 of these will be in public car parks. Another 20,000 will be in private locations like condos, offices, shopping malls. This is an initiative as part of the Singapore Green Plan 2030 to eventually phase out internal combustion engine vehicles. I'm feeling supercharged this morning with the future of EVs, not just in Singapore, but the region. It's a matter of time before Tesla officially launches in more Southeast Asia markets. Which one do you think will be next after Singapore? My hypothesis is Thailand, with Southeast Asia's largest car market and strong automotive manufacturing base. And for fun, if we look at Apple as an example, their Southeast Asia official Apple store opening started first with Singapore, then Thailand. One more thing, Tesla is going to announce their Q3 deliveries this weekend, which I believe is going to surprise many people. Please click the subscribe button down below if you'd like to watch my coverage on Q3 deliveries. If you found this video useful, please click the like button. See you in the next video and have a good weekend.